is the Davey Max Sports Program.
The Davey Max Sports Program, and here's your host, Dave McDonald.
Yes, woo! Sir. Woo! Okay, thank you, Roy.
Yeah.
All right. I love the applause, but I love more yelling. Yelling.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Dave's number one.
Yeah, that's better.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Davey Mac Sports Program, East Side Dave McDonald. That's my name, a.k.a. Davey Mac. With me, the new announcer, apparently, for the show, because we don't know where Pepper is. Ladies and gentlemen, also the musical director, Roy Schaefer.
Woo! Roy. Yeah.
Tickle those ivories a little bit more. Come on, let's go. Yeah. Come on, baby. Master engineer extraordinaire, the man in charge of everything technological-wise for the Davey Mac Sports Program, Shoto!
Yeah. Yes, that's me!
And sitting directly to my left, Chris Pepper Stanley.
Oh, wait a minute. Where's Pepper?
I don't know.
Chris, I don't know. Where is he?
It's a vacation here. It's a vacation there. It's a vacation over there. In the last, what is it, a month and a half, two podcasts, and he's missed two live shows on Sirius XM satellite radio.
We got to fire
which
him.
We do. In case whoa. People don't know, we do it. What?
We got to fire the guy.
Fire Roy Schaefer, letting it down.
Yes,
Roy throwing the smack it down onto Pepper right now.
Damn right. The guy's never here anymore.
I don't know what's going on either. You know, it's like a Howard Stern type of situation or something. I guess you make it to a certain part in radio, you only have to work, you know, 1 week in the actual summer.
Yeah, right?
But I don't know what's happening. You know, we're sitting here. We have a huge announcement to make, which is that, okay, I'm even going to make it right now.
Oh.
A very big announcement for the Davey Mac Sports Program, the podcast version, the iTunes version. The huge announcement we're making right now.
Oh.
Right now.
Right
Let's
now.
Do it.
Right now.
Yeah, let Pepper read about it.
Here's the announcement. Ready? On Monday. We here at the Davey Mac Sports Program are going to be making another huge announcement.
Yeah!
So that's the announcement. Is another big announcement will be made on Monday. And that will be the real announcement.
This is exciting.
We were going to make the announcement today. And if you're saying, Davey Mac, you're not on Mondays. Well, here's the thing. Next couple weeks, our schedule's changing up a little bit. We're going to be on Monday next week.
Yep.
Following week will be Thursday.
Yep.
If you're subscribing on iTunes, you just don't care about this. This is strictly for the Ustream audience.
That's right.
But the point is, we're going to be going early Monday because of the big announcement. Big announcement! Even bigger announcement! And the biggest announcement! Yeah! Woo! So it's very exciting. It's a very exciting time for the Davey Mac Sports Program. You know, we started this, me and the Pepper over there, who just, I don't
the
know
missing
what,
link.
What happened to him, but we started this 1984. Gradually but surely, we accrued a bigger cast, consisting of Roy Schaefer and Sean O. Fast Freddy. Who was the country guy who came in here that one
Ray
time?
Wiley Hubbard.
Ray Wiley Hubbard. And everyone there on Ustream watching. It's been fantastic. It was so good that SiriusXM said we need to put this show on Saturdays because we can never actually, this is what SiriusXM said. They go, we can't actually come up with our own ideas ever. Well, it's just one of our flaws. But because we see how great the show is on the internet, let's just take it and put it on our company. So there you go.
Brilliant.
They're always so creative there at Sirius.
They
go, let's see, can we look at what everyone else is doing? And instead of calling it a wrap-up show, it's an after-party show. And then this show is the post-game Jubilee hand job and sandwiches show where we recap what happened 15 minutes before, and then that's recapped somewhere else, and then we all recap with a circle jerk and spit each other and have a good time. Lots of recaps going on. Or here's an idea for a show. During a best of, let's make it a countdown, and we get a producer to say, here's what you heard this week. That's SiriusXM, the cutting edge of radio. Not here, my friends. Not here. Not on the David Mech Sports Program. We're making our own decisions. And this decision on Monday has us advancing, moving over, becoming affiliated with something very, very major. Right? Right?
Bigger than all of us.
Now, I want to get into Steve Nash, who two-time MVP. He is signed with the LA Lakers. He hates Kobe Bryant. He despises Kobe Bryant. And yet he chose to play with Kobe Bryant? It's a very interesting call. But before I do that, Roy, you were telling me how angry you were at Pepper for not coming to this show. You were under the impression that Pepper was coming to this particular
I was expecting
episode.
I was expecting to look over there and see him, but lo and behold, he's gone.
He's gone. And so now you not only are you doing the musical duties, you're also going to be doing the announcing duties as well?
Yeah, he's putting a lot on me here.
A lot of extra work.
A lot of extra work, yeah, seriously.
How do you feel about this situation?
I don't see my paycheck going up, filling in for the big man over there.
I mean, are you angry at Pepper?
A little bit, yeah. I mean, I don't want to tell. I would never tell him that on the air, but now that he's not here, yeah, screw him.
Oh, man. And I wish I could say that this was a joke, but this is very real.
Oh, it's no joke here. I don't joke around.
And there is going to be a feud because here's what happened. I noticed Roy Schaefer does not have that distinct aroma of marijuana on his clothing tonight. And when you're not smoked up, you tend to get a little angry.
That's
so
right.
The combination of the testiness. Yeah. And then the Pepper not showing up.
I'm agitated.
Okay.
Yeah.
Would you be agitated enough to? Would you want to kick Pepper in the stomach?
I'd kick him. Yeah. Yeah.
Man. If he was sitting here, would you kick him in the stomach?
If he was, if he didn't see it coming, definitely.
Okay. What if we blindfolded him?
Sucker kick.
What if we blindfolded him?
And said, someone in this room is about to kick you.
Put him on the couch. We blindfolded him, put him on the couch on all fours.
Yeah.
And pulled down his pants.
Oh, yeah.
And gave you a plunger, Abadou Diallo style. Would you give him that?
I'd give him the shave for sodomization.
This is disgusting.
I don't know.
What if, we're just saying this, you had two of Sean O's beer bottles.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And even though he said he didn't want it, you said, it's finger cuff time. One in the bum, one in the mouth. Would you do that?
Yeah, I'd find another one for his ear.
Ooh. Ouch.
What if we had a pet monkey in here?
Yeah.
Would you, at gunpoint, force Pepper to give the monkey a handy?
Yeah.
You would do that.
Damn straight.
This is one of the most shocking and ding ding, because this fight is on.
That's
the
right.
Roy Schaefer Pepper fight has officially begun.
That's right, yeah. Just for the record, he doesn't actually subscribe to the podcast. He won't hear this, right?
I think he will eventually. If not, I will certainly tell him all these things.
Yeah, awesome. Me too.
Yeah, you can be. I believe he's back with the Sirius show on Saturday.
Okay, baby.
Before that, I'm going to let him know all the things he said.
I'm even going to add some stuff in.
Yeah,
he didn't
let's
say.
Add some stuff.
I'll have to call in.
You're a German descent, right?
I am. Yeah, German Austrian.
Would you draw the Star of David on pepper, and then put him into a giant pizza oven? Would you do that?
All right, why not?
Yeah. Oh, man.
You know that's anti-Semitic.
Yeah, you are.
Even if Pepper is not a Jew, that's anti-Semitic.
All right. But that might be going a little too far.
All right. Now, this Steve Nett, by the way, I am indeed wearing a Harry Potter Quidditch jersey tonight.
I noticed that. Yeah.
Yeah, Roy looked over and says, is that a Harry Potter jersey? I bought it at Disney World when I went a couple weeks ago.
I didn't know Harry Potter was Disney affiliated.
No, you know what? He's not. It was in Universal.
Oh, okay.
We went to Universal, which is not right next to Disney.
Got it.
And they also, you know, they have great movie rides, Jurassic Park and stuff like that. So I got the Harry Potter jersey. That's my one memento that I brought back from Disney World.
Did you ride a broom around or something?
We did go on the Harry Potter ride, the special ride. Oh yeah, it's something that people don't actually know about me, which I thought, you know, most of the Davey Mac stuff is on the table. And most of my past is there.
This one's a little embarrassing.
But yeah, I guess this one I kind of keep to the vest, so I'll confess it right now. If you have some sad confessional music, I'll gladly say right now, I am a Harry Potter lover. And have...
Is that what they're called? Harry Potter fans?
Yeah. Harry Potter lover. I'm glad you find it humorous, Sean-O.
I love it, yeah.
Well, I'm just trying to state, to be honest, to be frank with the audience here.
I like the honesty. I'm
learning
a lot.
You know, your laughing hurts me, but that's fine.
I'm laughing out
of
surprise.
When I saw the first movie, I loved it so much, I saw it again that night at midnight.
Oh.
Then when I was a waiter, I would sometimes draw little Harry Potter cartoons in my food pad. You know, where you're supposed to take the orders?
Sure.
So it would be like it was an Irish pub, so it would be like one shepherd's pie, two Gaelic steaks, and then they would get a little tiny little miniature Harry Potter picture riding a broom.
Oh, and would you always put that little scar on his head?
Like a little lightning bolt.
The little SS?
No.
What?
It's just a lightning bolt. Thanks.
You sure? No.
And I bought every movie on DVD, and now that came out on Blu-ray, I bought the entire Blu-ray selection.
It's nice.
As well.
You show it to your
and
kids.
I love. Yeah, I have, but their interest isn't. It's not holding their interest yet.
Yeah.
I think they're a year or two away, and they'll get into it. I will force them to get into it.
All right. How are you gonna?
Not in any kind of way. The way Roy forced Pepper to do those various things, that I'm hoping to forget about, but I find it to be very magical, pleasant even.
Very witchy. Very a lot of.
Now, is this
young
sad?
Boys.
I sometimes dream that I'm Ron Weasley.
Yeah, it's a little sad.
Like, I dream that I'm, like, the grown-up Ron Weasley, and I have little adventures. And sometimes even, there's a scene in Harry Potter, I think it was the second film or third film, where Ron Weasley picks Harry up at his bedroom in a flying car. Sometimes when I'm driving, I pretend I'm in said flying car.
That's nice.
Yeah, I pretend I'm Ron Weasley on my way to, like, pick up Harry. I have a little, like, imagine little scenarios. Because when you drive as much as I do, I drive into the city from Jersey twice a week, you know. This week, I'm all over the freaking map. I'm going tomorrow to Roger Waters
in
Yankee Stadium, so I'll be driving in again. And sometimes you want to play little games to make the drive a little bit shorter.
Yeah.
So I pretend that I'm Ron Weasley, and I will sometimes spank it to Hermione.
Well...
a lot for dropping the music there.
Which
really making me shame.
Which version of Hermione? First movie or the last movie?
We don't need to talk about that, Sean.
All right.
Emma Watson is her real name. I know because I often will Google an image Emma Watson fake porn pics.
That's like Photoshop.
It's good too, because you can get like a big you know what in her mouth and you're like, wow!
Big carrot.
Emma! Look at that!
Size of that broomstick.
Anyway, this is a sports show, so I'm going to go into Mr. Steve Nash. And all I hear was how much he hates Kobe, how much Kobe hates Steve Nash.
Isn't Steve Nash, like, really old? Like, isn't he been around forever?
He's kind of old. He's 38, okay. I believe.
I remember him.
I believe he's around 38. Yeah, he's been in the league a long time.
Yeah.
He's been in the league a long time. But he is a two-time MVP, and even if he's not as great as he was in 05 and 06 when he won the MVP, he's still really, really good. He's a great point guard. So this could be what the Lakers need, but, I mean, he is adding an old guy to an already old team. You know, besides Bynum, who is young, but, I mean, Gasol, World Peace, Kobe, it's a very old team. We'll see what happens. But Kobe doesn't – I don't know if Kobe, it's going to take with Kobe – because, quite frankly, I'm not sure if he likes white people, Roy. Okay.
Racist.
That's racist. That's messed up.
It feels that way. He's always yelling at Gasol. Although, if he's from Spain, is that... Are you considered a white person if you're from Spain?
No.
Or you're Latino? But I'm saying Spain, the country in Europe. Because it's a European country.
Oh, yeah. Well, a Spanish person will tell you that...
They're white?
They're white, yeah.
But, you know...
South American would differ.
Yep. They would say that they're Latino.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. That's actually a big deal.
It's a big deal, really?
Yeah, tell them the
Does
Spanish,
it really matter?
If you call a Spanish guy that you're like South American, that's grounds for...
Oh, yeah, you're going to fight.
A guy from Spain, if you say you're Hispanic...
You're Hispanic?
They'll get upset.
Oh, yeah. Big time, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I can understand the point. I mean, if Italians don't get, you know, they get the white person, the Caucasian treatment, why shouldn't Spain? I mean, they kind of look similar to me. What do I know? I'm a redheaded Mick. You know, I'm not good at pointing out nationalities. I look like Ron Weasley. Oh, there he is. There's his one little sound effect. His one little racist sound effect that he uses over and over.
I got a little Latin in me.
No, you don't. It's a lie.
Yeah.
I've done some music for Dora the Explorer. I use that same sample.
Do you really?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah. Every time you get a little thing.
I got to be honest. I know. I appreciate all of your musical skills, but that is one of the shows that you just want to throw the television at a small child when you're watching Dora the Explorer.
Yeah.
That's unbearable.
She's constantly staring at you.
Blinking her stupid eyes. It's just annoying.
It's always the same show.
Yeah, it's horrible. Listen, so now you have Nash going to the Lakers, right? And now, on top of that, the Houston Rockets have offered, reports are, $30 million to LinSanity. Now, let me tell you something here. If the Knicks lose LinSanity, they are back to square one?
Yeah.
Is that the word?
There's less than square one.
Back
and
zero.
They are back in a hellhole! They don't have a point guard. They still will have Carmelo and Amari Stoudemire, who hate each other. Mm. And they're not going to have LinSanity to get the fans pumped up. The Knicks are in trouble. Because as we speak... The Brooklyn Nets are making all kinds of moves.
Yeah,
they re-signed Deron Williams, who's one of the best point guards in the league. They got a six-time All-Star in this Joe Johnson, and they're still trying to get Dwight Howard. I'm telling you this. If they get Dwight Howard, pencil me in. Davey Mack, number one Brooklyn Nets fan.
Wow.
If they get Dwight Howard. Okay? I also want to wait also until their record to see their record and see how good their record is. Because if their record isn't good, then I'm going to put my allegiance back to the Knicks, actually.
Sure. So.
And now that I think about it, whichever team wins an NBA championship in the next 10 years or so, that will be the team. When I revise it, between the Knicks and Nets, so hard. Whoever's in first place.
Yeah, you just...
Okay, that's the team. Or just whoever has a higher record. Will be the team that I root for.
You're just gonna root for the best team.
Or whoever, if whoever treats me better too, gives me some tickets, I'll root for them.
All right.
Or if Jay-Z wants to meet me, you know, or come into the Davey Mack Sports Program.
That'd be cool.
Maybe on this Monday for our big announcement show. Well, then I'm a Nets fan. I don't know who the Knicks could bring in. I mean, they don't have any celebrity owners. I don't want to talk to their owner, James Dolan, of Cablevision. Screw Cablevision!
Yeah.
What I want to talk to is Jay-Z and the Russian mobster who co-owned the Nets together. That's who I want to talk to. But if the Knicks have a better record, even if Jay-Z comes in, then I'm a Knicks fan. However... Maybe the Knicks have a better record, but the Nets get on a hot playoff run. They win a championship back on the Nets. Yeah. Now, having said that, if the Nets win a championship, right, but the Knicks then win two championships back on the Knicks. So, if somehow the Knicks win back-to-back championship, but the Nets come back and have a three-peat, I'm back on the Nets.
How's your back feeling, Dave?
My back feels fine. My neck does not. My neck is all out of whack. And then I tell to Roy Schaefer before the show, I said, Roy, you ever have to crack your fingers like your knuckles? Like that, right? You ever have to do that, Sean? Roy, have you ever had to do that? Dave McLetterman here. Have you ever had to crack your knuckles?
That's right, Dave. All the time.
You have to do that.
Crack that knuckle.
Well, let me tell you something here, Roy.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. My back feels like a bunch of knuckles have gotten into it, or my neck has anyhow, and I have to crack my neck every 5 to 6 minutes, right?
That's right, Dave. Don't get a stroke.
You know
Don't
what
get a stroke.
Now, what, okay, what are you talking about? Don't get a stroke, Roy Schaefer. Tell me.
Well, apparently, if you keep looking up, you're going to get a stroke.
Okay, Dave McLetterman here on his way out. I'll see you all in hell. Yeah, I love that music. Roy did say to me, you're going to get a stroke
if you look up. Yeah, apparently guys who shave while they look up towards the sky, when you bend your neck back like that, you really increase your chances of...
Now, I'm telling you, literally, I've had to crack my neck...
It's very dangerous.
At least 50 times today.
Very dangerous.
I slept on it wrong, and it's just... But if I don't crack it, it's like it... I can't describe it. It feels like small little mice... are somehow in my neck.
Oh, you are
and
so
if I
primed.
Crack my neck, it's like I'm cracking their necks and killing them.
There you go.
So that's why I keep wanting to crack my neck.
Yeah.
It's basically to just crack the small mice living in my neck's necks.
Yeah, that's
you understood?
That's fat globules.
And I'll tell you something else too, Roy.
Yeah.
I don't know if this is any kind of thing for a sign of the stroke, but I've noticed that the right side of my face and body is starting to feel a little paralyzed. Now, I don't know if that has anything to do with it, but let me tell you something. It's a slobber knocker. J.R. McDonald over here. And I gotta say, The Rock is here to stay. Every time I see that wrestling announcer, J.R.,
yeah.
Oh, I get the creeps, man.
Yeah, he's had a stroke.
He looks weird,
yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, well, the good thing is I know how to alleviate the stroke when I see the signs.
I know what you're going to do. You're going to open up this window and throw me right off the balcony.
Yeah, that's it.
Collect because that Roy Schaefer never wants a dead body in the Skinny Man Studios. He's basically like Eric Stoltz in Pulp Fiction.
That's right.
Get her out of my house!
You're worth more to me dead than alive, Dave.
Get the shot! A felt pen! A magic marker! A felt pen! Okay, man, put it in. I know what I'm doing. You put it in. Is that not one of the greatest?
Yeah, that's a great scene.
If you had to choose five most suspenseful scenes, individual scenes of all time,
okay,
that has to be there.
That's
Pulp Fiction where Uma ODs. That has to be there.
That's a good one.
Right?
Yeah.
What's another one?
I'm trying to think here.
There's got to be some more. You know, what I'll say is Taxi Driver.
Okay.
Towards the end, right before he goes on his killing spree, you feel the
tension.
Here's the tension. Yeah.
Yep.
Suspense.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about here. That's what we're talking about in the Davey Max Sports Program. Suspense! I'll give you another one. Last scene of Jaws,
yeah,
where Chief Brody and the boat. I just was more afraid.
Smile, you son.
Yeah, and I was so afraid that the boat was, he was going to be in the water.
Oh, yeah.
And that shark was just going to. Like in SeaWorld, just do a little trick where he just jumps a little bit and swallows Chief Brody whole.
I like the scene in The Warriors with Cyrus where he's going, "Can you dig it?"
Okay, you like that one. That's
very
a Roy.
Suspenseful to
All right.
Me, yeah.
All right.
Reservoir Dogs.
Reservoir Dogs.
Stuck in the Middle. I mean, the whole movie's suspense more.
Tarantino is huge.
But just walking out during Stuck in the Middle.
And the end, too, when he gets into one of his Mexican standoffs as you have.
Stop
in fact,
every
Mexican standoff is perfect, right? That Tarantino does. The end of True Romance. Yeah. The basement pub scene in Inglourious Basterds.
He's mastered that.
He has, right, Roy?
That's right.
I am still thinking about if Tarantino could have one genre left to conquer, because I'm very excited about this Western.
Yeah.
So you add that. That's another genre off the list. He's, you know, like horror and action and kung fu, and he's knocking them all off.
Checking them off the list.
I want one thing. I would love for him. I want to see a Tarantino sci-fi movie.
Ooh.
That's what I want to see next.
That's a good one.
I think, how many genres does he have left? I hope he doesn't ever go into the romantic comedy thing, because I don't think that would really work that well.
Yeah, musical
but
comedy.
But sports, like, you know, I'd like to see him maybe tackle a baseball movie or something like that. Maybe a boxing movie, you know.
Oh,
but
yeah,
he would inevitably get the comparisons to Raging Bull and, you know.
Yeah, bowling movie.
Oh, will you please, with the bowling.
What?
With the bowling already.
It's a whole subculture.
So, I don't know. It's just something to think about, Roy.
That's, yeah, now I'm thinking.
You still angry at Pepper?
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah.
If you do, you want to give him a message right now here on the Davey Mac Sports Program? Yeah. This is all of our show. This isn't just. I know my name is on the big marquee there.
Yeah.
And let's face it, I am the star.
You are the star,
right?
Dave,
would you agree with that?
I would. That's right.
Okay, but Starman doesn't mean that it's not also your show. You guys have ownership of it. Yeah. I mean, it's like I'm 98%, and you guys can split that measly 2%. I don't know if you want to do, like, you know, give Sean L 0.8, give Roy 1, and give Pepper 0.2, whatever you guys want to do.
Well, Pepper's not even here.
You could, okay.
Yeah, seriously.
So divvy it up then, 1% each.
All right, I'll take it, Sean. Yeah,
give a message to. Give
a
message.
Sounds good to me, right?
Give a message to Pepper right now.
A message to Pepper, man.
Yeah.
Wow.
And call him out, WWF style.
Well, you were the one angry before the show saying, wait, Pepper's not here? Again?
Just, you know what? I'm not even going to say angry. I'm just going to say...
Disappointed?
A little disappointed, yeah. A little sad that he's not here to share this with us.
What else? What do you want to call him?
I'm just going to
say... Are you going to make fun of his weight?
I'm going to withhold that one, but...
You were saying something in the hallway.
That's right. You sure
you
were.
Heard that. You heard that, huh?
I heard it.
I heard it, too. In fact, I was right next to you.
About the booze. Mark it, Sean. Oh, goddamn. He is like Pepper, huh? We have to we have to mark his curses to edit them out later for the iTunes. What about the you know, how you were saying substance abuse?
That's right. He's got substance abuse problems.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
He's a
booze. It's kicking in, Dave. It's kicking in.
Well, you said something like he doesn't know what he's doing.
Yeah.
He's walking around with his head up. You know what?
We do carry him. Let's face it. We do carry him for a lot of the show, right?
Right.
Yeah,
you're right.
You're saying he knows Jack and S
about
radio in
general.
That's
right. You're right.
Production.
Called him. You said, what was it? Piss poor attitude.
There you go.
Is that what you said?
Something like that, yeah.
Right? Negative?
Yeah, if it wasn't for that other
lazy.
That other thing he was involved with, where would he be, huh?
Listen. Get a hold of yourself, Roy. Get a goddamn grip. This is Pepper we're talking about. We're not going to be throwing him under the bus, okay? Right. Not the show before the big announcement on Monday.
You think he'll be here?
If he isn't here, we're going to sue. All three of us.
Okay.
I don't know how, but we're suing him.
I like the idea.
He'll be here. He's going to be here. He's going to be on the Sirius show on Saturday, Sirius XM, and then we'll be doing the show. Monday is next week's show. And we definitely need everyone to be subscribing on iTunes, yes?
That's right.
I mean, that's key. We appreciate you watching live on Ustream, but certainly be subscribing on iTunes. It helps us out. So there you have it. So you have Jeremy Lin. If the Knicks choke and do not get Jeremy Lin back, they are in a world of trouble. I am telling you flat out. That guy is the team. He's the exciting part of the team. I know you have Carmelo Anthony on it. But let's face it, this city fell in love with this LinSanity, with this Harvard guy.
Yeah, but you still think he has it?
Yeah, he'll be fine. Listen, LinSanity, he is not a top 5 point guard.
Because he hit a hot streak.
But he's in I would say he's like top 15, right? For a starting point guard? I mean, he's in the top.
How many teams?
Basically, what I'm saying is like around 30 in the NBA. So what I'm saying is he's in the first half.
Okay.
You know, he might even be higher than that. He might be like a top eight.
All right.
His stats are good. You know, he averaged close to 15 points and close to, just over 6 assists a game, right? Those are good stats for a point guard.
Even with those averages, it was like
need three, to have
it was
more
like three amazing games. And then
it was more than that. It was more than that. He had a huge win streak. Remember, it was, 9 or 10?
Is that many?
He put him on a 9 or 10. He totally changed the next season around. Mm. If there was no LinSanity, it was another garbage year for the Knicks.
Yeah.
And even when he got hurt, it was because of LinSanity shifted the momentum that then Carmelo was able to take the team on his back and the Knicks made the playoffs.
Right.
So there you have it. Well, I'll tell you one thing. It is kind of exciting for this Brooklyn Nets thing. And we used to live in Brooklyn, and we would have lived about 5 minutes from where the new arena is. We just got out once an NBA team came within tiny, minuscule walking distance.
Well, do you really want to be near a stadium? Isn't that like the typically where...
It was, though, in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
It was it wouldn't have affected the neighborhood. You had to walk... over like a highway kind of major road to get there.
Yeah.
So I think the our little neighborhood would have been fine on State Street in Brooklyn.
Okay.
But it's a decent point, Roy.
Yeah.
You know what? Give yourself 7 points. Sean, I know you have zero. So
well, how about this? Why don't you see if you can move back into that old apartment? Bam.
A one-bedroom apartment, Sean, with a family of four and a three-legged dog.
Yeah.
Roy, give yourself 7 more points. It's 14. Just in case you didn't realize, Sean O, this has become a game. This whole thing, meaning life, is one big game. And so far, Roy has 214 points. You have 78.
All right.
And Pepper's got even less than that.
Whoa!
Oh, no.
Roy, Shafe!
Man.
I mean, the anger is just pouring out of the sockets right there.
Calm down, dude.
Yeah. You can't see it. But my eyes are flaring.
Well, I know, because you always have sunglasses on.
Yeah.
And it's a radio.
Because of the Schaefer thing.
But behind it...
That's a part of the Schaefer thing,
yeah,
huh?
That's right.
That everyone who is a Schaefer needs to be wearing sunglasses at all times?
Yeah. You don't realize it, but I do this show, entire show, with my eyes shut.
What was with the pause?
I had to figure out where the keyboard was.
That was so weird. Oh, my gosh. How much time are we in?
We got 30 minutes deep. You want to
keep
going?
We'll keep going for now. And if we need
a break,
we'll take
one. We haven't taken a
break in a while.
Yeah,
I'm going to roll.
We need to... we'll keep rolling for a little bit. Now, what else is on the sports horizon? I have to look at the computer for my show prep because Roy Schaefer gives me a thing while I'm driving to New York. It says, can you print out your show prep?
Because
the printer at Skinny Man doesn't work. Thanks for giving me a heads up. I appreciate it. Yeah, I'll just press the print button in my glove compartment in my awful car.
My
awful 1984 Saturn.
You should just get a printer in your house. And it would be fine.
We have 3 of them. And 0 of them work.
Okay.
Good thing Pepper's not here.
E-Rock gave us a printer, too. The thing is as big as the Death Star. I don't know what kind of printer this is. It's bigger than this goddamn table.
Oh, my God.
And then I plugged that one in, and it didn't work. So now I just basically use it to eat dinner in the dining room off of. That's what
nice
it's
table.
Used for. Yeah. It's ridiculous. No, you're right. I should invest in a printer. You know what I'm saying?
Get a wireless one if you can. It works off your Wi-Fi network.
So I could print it off my phone?
Yeah.
That's
totally.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Huh? Totally. Well, what happened with the printer here at Skinny Man? What is this?
We ran out of toner and we forgot to order more toner.
Ran out what? Oh, toner.
Toner. Toner. Toner. Yeah, ink. Yeah. Ink.
I thought you said tar.
Yeah, we ran out
we got a,
tar.
Yeah, we got a tar printer.
Let's just... I don't need to... I heard... I could just see... I could just see things occurring. Let's just keep... let me tell you something. This Andy Murray, right? You follow the tennis at all, Roy Schaefer?
Once in a while, yeah.
Okay. So, this Andy Murray, I believe he's from... I don't know how this actually works, but if you're watching Wimbledon right now, Andy Murray is a guy who keeps getting to the semifinals at Wimbledon.
Just keeps getting knocked.
And if you look at it, it says GBR next to his name. Great Britain.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
But he's from Scotland.
Huh.
But now they're somehow claiming him and saying he'll be the first British person to win the men's tournament, singles tournament, since 1936. The first guy since 36 in Wimbledon. You know, Wimbledon obviously being in England. right? Being in close to London.
Yeah.
I don't know how that. How does that work? Where you're Great Britain. It's Great Britain.
It's within the United Kingdom, I think, and then.
Yeah. Well, they say Great Britain. I thought Great Britain was specifically for England.
Yeah. Try telling that to an Irish guy.
That's my point.
Yeah.
So I saw Braveheart. I thought they got freed. Wasn't the whole point of the movie that the guy threw the sword in the air and McWallace, Wallace?
They caught him at the end.
They caught him, but then they got, what was the other guy? Robert the Bruce. He throws the sword, or one of the guys throws the sword, something happens. Yeah, what is this, the bagpipes? In 1066, the year of our Lord, they fought like poet laureates. They fought like Scotsmen. Bang, bang! Yeah! I don't know if this is exactly like Scottish music. I feel like I'm either in a cantina from Star Wars or in some Hindu Bollywood movie. This is the most bizarre sounding bagpipes this Scot has ever seen. And yet he's still making no effort to change the sound of the bagpipes. I feel like the Maharishi's about to enter. It's like the Beatles' 1968 trip to India. Again, I ask, is this supposed to be bagpipes, Roy? Doesn't exactly sound like the soundtrack to Brave.
Oh, here we go. Ready? Oh, here comes Dave.
Ah, that's a little bit better, Roy. That sounds like bagpipes. Specifically, it sounds like the end of Dead Poets Society, where they all stand on the desk, you know? Oh, Captain, my Captain! My Captain! The people on Ustream are just watching my legs, Sean! It's not your fault, Robin Williams! It's the dad from My 70s Show! He's why the kid killed himself! Speaking of that, I really thought that actor was gonna have a bigger career! I thought he'd be in a lot of movies. Instead, Ethan Hawke was the one who broke out. Goes to show you Davey Mac knows jack and shit about Hollywood. Mark it, Sean. You're gonna have to mark that one. Oh, Captain, me Captain.
Robin Williams goes.
I think the Wes Anderson, you can keep playing that. I think the Wes Anderson style of dialogue started with that movie because he did a very Wes Anderson, delivered a Wes Anderson-ish type line. After the kids all say, Captain, my Captain, Robin Williams looks at them and goes, thank you, boys. Thank you. And that is very Wes Anderson-ish, if you ever notice, like, whenever he has a thing of, you know, it's like, it's true, Royal Tenenbaum. It's true. So it is. So it is. Food for thought. May I just say this, too? That movie, Dead Poets Society, directed by a man named Peter Weir. Say,
from the Grateful Dead. Now, I take it it's a different Peter Weir.
First of all, I believe the dead player's name is Bob Weir.
All right, Bob Peter.
No, yeah. All right, fine, I Dave. Splitting hairs. No, there's two different people. So, whatchamacallit. But I always thought Peter Weir's career very underrated because he's made a bunch of great movies, and each one totally different than the next. Let me give you a little... I'm not even needing IMDb for this. I'll give you a little rundown here.
Here we go.
Witness with Harrison Ford, suspense movie.
Oh, I like that movie.
The Truman Show, which I love. Yeah. I just can't get enough of The Truman Show.
Great concept.
Deadpool with Society, Academy Award nominee. Yeah. Okay, both for Best Picture, Director, and for Robin Williams. Mm-hmm. I love this movie a lot. And it was also nominated for Best Picture, Master and Commander, with Russell Crowe.
Never saw that one.
And he's done another one, a fifth movie. Oh, do you ever see the movie Fearless, starring Jeff Bridges? He survives a plane crash.
Oh, yes,
Rosie
absolutely.
Isn't that that's a very underrated and phenomenal movie?
Great movie. Yeah.
Now listen, that's five movies. Each one is totally different than the next.
Yeah.
I think he's quite underrated. I think, like, in terms of great directors, what's the deal? How come Peter Weir isn't getting any love? I'm giving you love right now, Peter. Anyway, back to this Andy Murray character. So, again, I'll ask. I really did think if you're Scottish, then you would not be a part of Great Britain. And I understand Sean's point that the United Kingdom is supposed to somehow encapsulate all those countries, I guess.
Yeah.
But I didn't think Great Britain also...
I'll tell you what. We were going to England. We get stopped at customs in Scotland.
When you guys were playing?
Yeah, Sean and I went overseas.
For the band. Okay.
Yeah, so we landed in Paris, took a connection flight to Scotland then to get to Exeter. So in Scotland, that's when they went put us through customs, and they almost didn't let us in because, Roy told them we were there to play a festival, and they wanted to see our working visas. And
we didn't.
Oh, really? Man. Yeah. But you got in somehow.
Yeah, we got in.
Yeah, we had a little ball buster customs
agent. That's pretty... ball buster, that's what you're supposed to do.
Even the other custom guys were
maybe
like,
you shouldn't have
sorry
told them.
He's new, you know?
Maybe you just don't tell them next time. Next
believe show. Me. Listen. Did I just shot him a look?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We'll never do that again.
Okay.
But so that being said, I get the impression that obviously in order to enter England, I had to go through Scottish customs, and that's where the customs happen. That's where
right. Go.
So there is some sort of connection there.
There is. All right. Well, listen. I mean, obviously they all share that island.
Yeah.
But I just was under the impression. I just think it's kind of chintzy, if you ask me. Because what to me is it was what they're trying to do is saying, listen, it has been since 1936 that an Englishman has won Wimbledon, and that's a ridiculous stretch of time
when
the tournament is in England.
Yeah.
And let's face it, Wimbledon is the number one.
Yeah,
and I love U.S. Open because it's here in New York
and
everything, and the French Open's cool, and Australian Open, I really don't care about that much. But Wimbledon is the main tennis tournament, and so it's a little bit embarrassing that an Englishman hasn't won. So I feel like they're kind of taking over this Andy Murray guy. And then you hear him, and it's like Amish from Braveheart. The guy sounds like he should be in Trainspotting.
Well, what network do they air Wimbledon on now?
It's been on ESPN. I think it's been on ESPN, and then it should switch to either, NBC or
CBS.
Right.
I remember it used to be on HBO all the time.
It was on HBO.
That's how I learned the rules of tennis, because I was dying to watch
some TV. I always thought HBO did a great job with it, too.
I just hated it at the time. I was like trying to watch a movie or something. Put on a stupid tennis.
HBO was excellent because since they didn't have commercials, you would get a lot of little features and stories
you'd see
were cool.
You'd see every match going
back and
forth,
and so it was better than ESPN's coverage, but ESPN's not doing a terrible job. But tomorrow, I believe tomorrow is the big match between Federer and Djokovic. I think it's tomorrow. Maybe it's Saturday. But those two guys are the guy. So this Andy Murray, he's made it to the semifinals the last four years. This will be his fourth year.
Yeah.
And he's still yet to win. So
always a bridesmaid.
The pressure is going to be just enormous on this great British person, I guess I'm supposed to call him.
Any relation to Bill Murray?
There is. They're actually brothers.
They are. He's got a lot of brothers.
Yeah.
So
I've been reading a lot about Bill Murray lately.
You have, right?
Yeah, he's been showing up at like house parties
in Brooklyn.
Yeah,
yeah. Just
that's his new thing. He's been doing that for a couple of years now.
He just shows up at a party for 20 minutes.
He shows
and then
up,
he leaves, and goes to another.
He shows up at parties and he does
bars,
no entourage,
bartends.
Yeah, no entourage. He just shows up, flirts with the girls.
I think that the Lost in Translation character has gotten into Bill Murray's soul, and he almost can't leave that behind.
Yeah, apparently he actually
I don't
speaks
care.
To girls.
I love Bill Murray.
He speaks to girls but in like a fatherly figure kind of way. Like he'll
which makes it all the more creepy.
I guess so.
But it's Lost in Translation.
Yeah.
I can't wait till my midlife crisis. I'm going to have a good one.
You are?
Oh, yeah.
When is the midlife crisis supposed to happen? 50?
I think 45, 50, yeah.
Yeah. I was going to say, I mean, 50, then midlife, you're anticipating to live to 100.
Yeah.
You think you're going to make it there?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, jeez.
The way I'm going, probably, I think I passed my midlife already.
Oh, yeah. That's sad.
I agree.
Now, this Josh Hamilton, he has gotten more votes, 11 million votes, than any all-star in all-star history. Can you believe that?
It's all of his old drug addict friends.
That's what I'm saying. Well, what I'm saying is, you know, this country, we're quite forgiving, aren't we?
Guess so.
I mean, I don't care. Who would care if the guy's smoking crack left and right and doing a little bit of meth?
Like
let's be honest.
Yeah, shooting babies.
Oh.
Yeah.
He fires another missile at Pepper somehow.
Yeah.
Defenses, you know?
Pepper.
Here's Roy Schaefer. B-12! B-12! Boom!
You sunk my pepper ship.
You sunk the pepper ship.
Right now, he's just in a skinny little Speedo on the beach.
Sipping
a daiquiri.
I don't know where the hell is that guy. He just disappears. So Josh Hamilton, 11 million votes. That's ridiculous. We do have the breakdown of how people vote for him. 2 million of those people were crack addicts. 1.3 million of the people voting for Josh Hamilton loved meth. 4 million enjoyed being drunk in a bathroom. And the rest had bad tattoos on their arms while they annually and drunkenly let sorority girls do body shots off their chests and inevitably apologize 24 hours claiming to be born-again Christians until they do the exact same thing in downtown Dallas a year later. Yeah. So that's the official breakdown.
Makes sense.
Okay. Okay, baby. Hey, Dennis Miller here. No, that's okay, Sean. Oh, I was just a quick Dennis Miller. Oh, go ahead, play the music. I know you love playing the music. It's just a good song anyway.
He does love your dad.
I have it on my iPhone.
I like the song.
It's a nice song to think about.
It reminds me of Real Genius.
Well, yeah, it was the song of Real Genius.
It was the ending credits.
I think more Dennis Miller for some reason.
Well, yeah, he used it in his theme song.
Yeah, that's right. Holy
reminds you of Pepper.
What?
Everybody wants to rule the world, but they don't show up!
Oh!
Man.
Look at them! Roy Schaefer with a knockout punch. Meanwhile, I'm wearing my Quidditch jersey like a professional maniac over here. Let me tell you something. That Harry Potter, that was one good-looking 16-year-old. Let me tell you something. I'm saying right here, bad Dennis Miller impression right here. My favorite Harry Potter movie was when he was naked on the Broadway stage. Let me tell you, huh? I got to check out that. What was going under there? Lots of magical hair on the undercarriage, if you know what I'm saying. Bad Dennis Miller impression. Good night! So that's just life, my friend, you know?
Yeah.
Roger Waters tonight at Yankee Stadium. Sports related because it's in the...
It's tonight? One of the
Friday.
Oh.
Friday night.
Today's Thursday.
Today is Thursday. You're right. What's that song?
Mother.
Mother, do you think they'll drop the bomb? Mother, do you think they'll like this song? Mother, do you think they'll try to break my balls? Ooh, I build a wall. Hush now, baby. Don't you cry. Mama's gonna make all of your nightmares come true. And Mama won't let anyone dirty get through. Mama's gonna keep you under her wing. She won't let you fly, but she might let you sing. Mama's gonna sing, baby, cozy and warm. Ooh, babe. Of course, Mama's gonna help build the wall. What, we got to sing it again now? Now I have Roy playing the song over here on the keyboard. Brother, now I have to hear you played it. Like, let's see how good of a job we did. Yeah. Sounds a little different when Roger Waters does it.
Worse. Sounds a little worse, I think, is what you meant to say.
Well, I mean, we did the best we could. We really didn't practice that at all.
Huh.
All right, that's good. We heard enough. We heard enough. So this isn't a goddamn Pink Floyd show over here.
Plenty
this
of
is a
that.
Sports show.
Could be. Yeah.
Plenty of time for that on Friday.
Tony La Russa is having a little battle with the Reds manager, Dusty Baker, because La Russa, who won the World Series, obviously with the Cardinals, when you win the World Series, or when you get to the World Series,
yeah,
you are then the manager of your respective All-Star team the next year. And your job is to choose the reserves. The fans choose the starting lineup, and your job is to choose the reserves. And
breaking news, Dave.
Yeah, give it
this
to me.
This just in.
Give it to me.
Lynn.
Jeremy Lynn?
To Houston.
Oh, I knew it! I knew it!
I tell you
one thing. Who gave us that information?
The O&A kid.
The O&A kid.
And
fantastic job.
Prior to that, it was Brian Hubley.
Brian?
And O&A kid.
Okay. Brian and the O&A kid. I want to somehow give them both EastsideDave.com stickers. I don't know how, so why don't you just email me your address at didvod@gmail.com. D as in David, I, D as in David, V as in vehicle, O, D as in David at gmail.com. Yes, Shano?
You could just screen cap this and then make a sticker out of it.
That's a little cheap, don't you think? I feel like they deserve the actual adhesive portion of the goddamn sticker.
Just give them what they want.
No, they want to be able to put it.
They want it now, Dave.
They both get it. That's what you get. Wow, can you freaking believe this?
I can believe it.
The Knicks are going to be terrible next year. Meanwhile, if the Nets sign Dwight Howard.
They will.
Well, they're close, but they're still going to do it. If the Nets sign them Dwight Howard, the Nets are going to be so much better than the Knicks.
Yeah.
And they are going to own New York. They are going to be hip.
Yep.
They had their owner is Jay-Z.
Yeah,
can it get any better than that?
They're in Brooklyn.
They're in Brooklyn, which is Mr. Hip now.
Yeah.
Of any of the five boroughs. Even Manhattan. Even Brooklyn is just, they crap on Manhattan at this point.
Oh, totally.
You know?
They're all going to have to wear those
glasses. And by the way, where did I live for over a year? I think maybe, 2 years I lived? Where I live?
State Street.
State Street in what borough?
Brooklyn.
Which means I am then Mr. Brooklyn Nets fan, especially in light of this Jeremy Lin situation.
You called it.
I did call it, right?
Yeah.
What a shock. I'll tell you what. Never, ever fail to understand that the New York Knickerbockers under this owner, Jim Dolan, will let you down. Ever. Never fail to grasp that this ship has no direction and does not know what the hell they're doing. I mean, all this kid did with Jeremy Lin is put the entire New York City. Remember what we talked about for 3 weeks?
Yep.
And quite frankly, who was paying attention to the NBA at all?
Nobody.
No one.
Nobody.
I'm even a sports fan. I'm a basketball fan.
Knick fan.
And I wasn't watching the goddamn thing. So here's what I have to say to Jeremy Lin. Jeremy!
Oh boy.
My Jeremy! Goodbye, Jeremy! Enjoy yourself in Houston! We love you as a New York Knickerbocker! Now get the hell out of here! Enjoy Houston! Jeremy! Goodbye, Jeremy! Your short time as a New York Knickerbocker was sensational. Now I have to go home and jerk off. Ah, 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 ah. and Sean O on the drums.
Military style.
I can't believe this, man. I mean, this is a really big deal. The Knicks are so bad. They are such a bad organization. I mean, they really are. And I have to say, it goes all back to this owner. This owner is so bad.
How long has he had the team?
For at least a decade.
Well, that's why they're so terrible, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, it just distinctly coincides with this. And and they traded, despite the fact that everyone knew that Carmelo only wanted to be a Knick, and they could have literally waited 3 months to have... Carmelo was going to be a free agent a couple years ago, right. And they could have waited, not given up anything. The impulsive Knicks owner said, no, you know what? Forget it. I have to have Carmelo now.
Yeah.
So they shipped away this Gallinari and a bunch of their good young talent, and now they have another young guy who captures everyone's imagination, and they don't pony up and give. He was not asking for a ton of money. The Rockets reportedly gave him, if it was the same deal, I don't know, the people at home would know better. But what I heard was $30 million for 4 years.
Whoa.
That's a lot of money, don't get me wrong. But that's something that the New York Knickerbockers, who play in Madison Square Garden, can afford.
Yeah, right.
And I know that there's a salary cap, blah, 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 and all this nonsense. The Knicks needed to re-sign that guy. Horrible job.
Unbelievable.
I'm disgusted. I just want to get out of here.
That's like us trading Pepper for the O&A kid. Or
Jeremy
something.
Lin gets reported.
The O&A kid showed up tonight.
$30 million. $30 million offer.
It's $30 million for 4 years.
Yeah.
So there you go. So again, the Sportsmaster gives you everything that you need to know. That's a disgrace. All right, let's get the heck out of here.
Yeah, let's do this.
I mean,
that's it.
We
did it.
Yeah, we did it, baby. We did it.
Yet again.
It was a good one. So listen, I have a few little words. That's the intro.
This is the intro.
Let's do it again, guys. So much more fun without Pepper here.
Well,
let's do it again.
Might as well pump it up, huh? Can't take that one.
No,
back.
Let's
sorry, everyone.
Let's play
I
the
field.
Let's do the other way. Okay. So, a couple of little words. Make sure you're listening on Saturday to Davey Mac Sports Program XL. Different show. Live. You listen to us, and I believe Pepper will be at that show, but who knows this guy?
Yeah,
it's like Axl Rose all of a sudden. I don't know what's going to happen. All I know is I'm going to be here.
Yeah. Pepper Rose.
I'm going to rock the microphone no matter where the Davey Mac is.
That's right.
Okay?
Yeah.
Then on Monday, we have no show next week on Wednesday or Thursday. Our show is going to be on Monday. That's when the show is.
Yeah.
We only do a show once a week on the podcast. It'll be on Monday, but that'll be the big, huge announcement show. And there you have it. Wow.
Break it up the week.
So Brian sent me his address. I need the O&A kid to send me his address. Didvod, D-I-D-V-O-D @gmail.com.
Do
and
it.
If anyone else wants to email me and give me a little conversation pieces,
yeah.
I'll be receptive to that, too.
Pictures of male genitalia as well.
Okay, fine. Anyway, for the Davey Mac Sports Program, Eastside Dave McDonald.
Yeah.
Sean O and Roy Schaefer saying good night, everyone. Yeah.